Albert is truly a person that believes you need to think big to make an impact on this world. He wants people to think what's beyond our imagination.
Albert is a very unique leader. He's visionary. He sees things before other people do.
Albert truly thinks that the role of a pharmaceutical company is to bring forward breakthroughs that change patient lives.
I would say what excites me the most about Pfizer's impact on global health, on public health, is the scale and the impact that we could have. We are moving the needle. We are changing patients' lives. And that's something that gives us a lot of pride.
When it came to our work in the pandemic, Albert was front and center, leading the effort.
Being part of the solution, making the leap, inspired a lot of scientific curiosity to think about how could Pfizer uniquely influence the pandemic.
Albert was really clear about what we needed to do. Take care of our workers and colleagues around the world, ensure the steady supply of medicine, and importantly, bring forward a vaccine in record time.
He embedded himself in the team like a team leader, and I've never thought someone in his role would have the time or the passion to do that.
That decision of Albert's to put himself at the center of this project made all the difference.
We were truly unique in bringing all of our resources to bear. And what elicited that response was really Albert's initial commitment that the remit of a pharmaceutical company is to stand up when it's needed at most.
This year, we're going to reach 2 billion people with our vaccine. If you extrapolate the magnitude, the impact that this will have in health, the impact that will have in lives saved, is enormous. And that's only about the vaccines or the therapeutics, because if you start adding our cancer drugs, if you start adding other vaccines, our medicines against cardiovascular diseases, you are making a difference.
We have a rallying cry at Pfizer. Science will win. And yet science can't win if we don't have wonderful, talented, dedicated scientists. It is for that reason that educating young people about science is fundamental to us.
Everyone deserves a chance to explore their curiosity and learn the language of science.
It's truly an honor for us to be associated with the Cold Spring Harbor Laboratories DNA Learning Center.
Cold Spring Harbor Laboratories, I think the reputation of this institution precedes everything else. Things that were discovered here open the doors for medicines that saved humans' lives to be developed. And of course, 8 Nobel Prize winners were calling this institution home.
Our partnership with Pfizer has been a critical part of our success. We can work with underfunded school districts and reach students that might not have access to the type of enrichment programs we can provide.
I'm a strong believer that we need to attract people in science during the early years when still they are shaping their personalities and they're shaping their interests.
Albert cares about people. He cares that the medicines we make find their way to people all over the world. And that sense of humaneness, of caring, will certainly be embedded in whatever his legacy may be.
I look forward for many more years with Albert's leadership and take on new big challenges.
To give hope to people, hope through science. This hope can only be developed when we behave not only as good scientists, but also as people with integrity.